Hey everybody, this is Akaya coming at you. I'm actually still in the process of still finishing up my henna. I have already installed it. I have a video on that, so if you will please watch that. I'll show you how to install henna, how to mix it up and all that good stuff. Now what I have done is I actually, from the last y'all had seen, I was actually putting some conditioner in my hair. So what I did was I mixed up all the different conditioners that I have. I think I used like 3 different conditioners. I mixed it all up because when you do your henna, it makes your hair drier, you know, so you want to make sure you use a lot of different moisturizing things, especially when your hair is natural. Even when it's not natural, you always want to make sure that it's moisturizing things that you're using. And what I did was I actually put saran wrap all around my head. I don't use it like normal people use saran wrap. I just take like the whole thing of saran wrap out the box and just wind it all around my hair, and then just wind up just tearing it off instead of trying to use a saran wrap, because it was crazy trying to do that. So I did stay under the hair dryer for 30 minutes. Can you believe it? I can't, because I hate the hair dryer. But what I did, I found out last time I got under the hair dryer, I think for like maybe 15 minutes. The best thing to do is get on your laptop. Because I was just working on my website, and by the time I know it, it was like 30 minutes was up. And I actually wasn't even done updating it. So if y'all would take a look at my website, I also have the way to do henna too. So my website is akaya.shutterfly.com. I'm going to put it somewhere in the sidebar so you can see it. But again, y'all just got done deep conditioning. Once I get done deep conditioning, I'm not going to shampoo at all. Because remember, I shampooed yesterday. So you guys, do not shampoo after henna. Because to me, if you do a rinse, you wouldn't shampoo after that, so you don't want to rinse out the henna, which is, I mean, the henna's gone anyway, but you know what I'm saying. I just think, to me, you might want to wait on washing your hair. I just did a bunch of different, just basically did a deep conditioning. I just cold washed my hair, and again, you guys, I had no problem taking the henna out at all. So I will be showing you some video, I mean, some pictures on how my hair looked. I really didn't see a significant color change, but they said I could be able to see it in the sun. So I have not been out in the sun yet, so I will take some pictures for y'all when it get dry and out in the sun to see if I see a difference in the color as well as the texture. So I'll let you guys know once it, you know, gets dry and, you know, I'll let you guys know. Everybody, if you haven't, if you will please rate, comment, and subscribe, and be blessed. Bye. Hey, YouTube, I am officially done henna in my hair. I like it. It's really, really nice to me. I think it's, I'm not really for sure if it's the kinky curly or what it was, but something just got my hair texture like totally different. It's more curlier, more tight coil, and I really, really like it. What I did use though, this time, is the Super Shaping Spray Gel by Garnier Fructis. Y'all, I like it. To me, it's good, just like the kinky curly pudding. And guess how much I paid for it? $3.39. Yes, this is a product for, don't take this wrong, but usually that white people use. So I'm telling you guys, don't stay shy of the products for white people, because their products is just as good as ours. The only difference is their texture is different. But when it comes to hair is just protein. And as long as you make sure it's same curling or moisturizing, you can be able to use it for natural hair. And it does a really, really good job. But my review on henna, I love it. When I got in the sun, I did see a little bit of color, but not really that much more color that was different than it already was. But they said once I get out in the sun to take pictures, I can be able to see it. And once my hair dries, maybe I can be able to see it also. But as we speak right now, I don't see like a red color or anything. But I'm glad I did it, and I'm most definitely do it again. Maybe the more applications I do, the better it'll be. My experience was real good. Yeah, I wanted to tell y'all one thing. I did buy a new product because one of my YouTubers told me to buy it. And it's really, really good for your edges, to get your edges like slick back and stuff. It's called Luster Re-Nutrition Slick Stick. So again, it's a Luster Slick Stick. You can get it from Sally's. That's where I got it from. It was $5.99. You can also get it from Amazon. Again, it's a Luster Slick Stick. It makes your edges look really, really pretty. Let me see, did I get anything else? I think I pretty much went over. Oh, yeah. I had headbands and stuff. They were very, very uncomfortable. Y'all know how uncomfortable headbands is. One thing I'm going to start doing is I'm actually going to start making my own headbands. And I will be making videos and stuff of how to make your headband also, because you have to make sure it's comfortable. Because when you're having natural hair and you have your hair back, you don't want to take it off and you have, like, your scalp is, like, cutting in two. Because I have had a client that her like she would had her actual little tie thing so tight that it was like cutting into her scab, and you don't want to do things like that. You want to make sure it's more as comfortable as possible. So if it's not comfortable for you, you need to take it off and find something that is comfortable. I did try these right here. I actually have a black. They came in white. They came in all kind of colors, and they got like the little claps right here. And what I did was I doubled it. And you guys, so far, so good. It's very comfortable. Very, very comfortable. So if you're trying to find a comfortable headband, you may want to try this. And the good thing about it is they come in different colors. So whatever, you know, hair color that you have or whatever style you have on, you can be able to use them. I always use the black. But again, you guys, I'm going to start making headbands. And hopefully y'all can start making them with me. I mean, because it's always good to just try to do as much as possible when it comes to natural hair. You want to always make sure it looks pretty. And again, thanks for watching, and I hope everybody take care and be blessed. And if you're thinking about Henna, yes, go ahead and do it. It's an awesome thing, and it's easy to do as long as you follow the right thing. And I'll have a whole video to show you how to do the whole process. If you haven't, if you would please comment, rate, and subscribe. Take care and be blessed, and I'll chat with you guys later. Bye.